discouraging. So Monday morning, I decided that I was gonna go and, okay, just go start it again. And I did it, and I was driving to Hannaford's to go shopping, and I had forgotten it again. And maybe I had said it 100 times, and I had forgotten it again. And I came back, and I was standing in the kitchen, and I said in my prayer to the Lord, "Oh Lord, I don't think I can do this. I can't do this. And I'm just fooling myself that I can do this, and I just can't do this." And I don't hear delusional voices or anything. But he placed in my heart the knowledge, yes, you can. Yes, you can. And so now, maybe I've said it 2,000 times. And do I know it? I don't know. Pray that I do. I want to. And these are the words of God. Sorrows and acquainted with grief, and as one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. And upon him was the chastisement that has brought us peace. And by his wounds, all we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. And the Lord laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted. Yet he opened not his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. By oppression and judgment he was taken away. And as for his generation, who considered that he was cut off out of the land of the living, stricken for the transgressions of my people? And they made his grave with the wicked, with a rich man. Although he had done no violence and there was no deceit in his mouth.
But it was the will of God to crush him. He has put him to grief when he makes his soul an offering for guilt. He shall see his offspring. He shall prolong his days. And the will of the Lord will prosper in his hand. Out of the anguish of his soul, he shall see and be satisfied. By his knowledge shall the righteous one, my servant, make many accounted righteous, and he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore, I will portion him with the many, and he will spoil with the strong. Because he laid out, poured out his soul to death, and was numbered with the transgressors. Yet he bore the sin of many and makes intercession